Welcome to today's class on vector analysis. Today we discuss circle of curvature for plane curves. The circle of curvature or the oscillating circle at a point P on a plane curve where the curvature is not equal to zero is the circle in the plane of the curve, that is tangent to the curve at P, and it has the same curvature of the curve at P and it lies towards the concave or inner side of the curve. The radius of curvature of the curve at P is the radius of the circle of curvature. So radius of curvature is rho is equal to 1 by kappa. So the circle of curvature or the oscillating circle at a point P is the circle with these three properties. It is tangent to the curve at P and has the same curvature the curve has at P and lies towards the concave or inner side of the curve. And radius of curvature is 1 by kappa. Now we do a problem. Find the oscillating circle to the parabola y is equal to x square at origin. So here we have to find the equation of this circle, the circle in the pink color, for which we have to find the curvature of the curve y is equal to x square at origin, so that we can find the radius of the circle. From the radius of the circle, we can find the center of the circle. So we have to find this length. So this will be rho, that is equal to 1 by kappa, where kappa is the curvature of the curve y is equal to x square at origin. So rho is equal to 1 by kappa, so that the center will be 0 rho. So from that we can find x minus 0 the whole square plus y minus rho the whole square is equal to rho square is the equation of the circle. In this case, because the center is on y axis, so we have to find the curvature of the curve at zero. So for which, so the given curve is y equal to x square, so we parameterize it. So let x equal to t, x of t equal to t. This implies y of t equal to t square. Therefore, r of t equal to x of t I plus y of t j, that is equal to t I plus t square j is the parameterization of y is equal to x square. We have to find kappa at 0, 0, so that the required rho is 1 by kappa at 0, 0. We have kappa equal to 1 by modulus of v times modulus of dt by dt. We have v is equal to dr by dt. This is equal to, we have r of t is ti plus t square j. So dr by dt is I plus 2tj. Therefore, modulus of V equal to square root of 1 plus 4 t square. Therefore, modulus of V at origin 0, 0 is square root of 1 plus 4 into 0. So, this is root 1. That is equal to 1. And we have t is equal to v by modulus of v. So this is equal to 1 by root 1 plus 4 t square I plus 2t divided by square root of 1 plus 4 t square j. that is t equal to 1 plus 4 t square the whole raised to minus 1 by 2 I plus 2t into 1 plus 4 t square the whole raised to minus 1 by 2 j. Now we have to find dt by dt. Dt by dt equal to minus 1 by 2 into 1 plus 4 t square the whole raised to minus 1 by 2 minus 1 into d by dt of 4 t square, so that is 8 t into I plus, here you have to apply product rule, so 2 t into minus 1 by 2 into 1 plus 4 t square the whole raised to minus 1 by 2 minus 1 into 8 t plus 2 into 1 plus 4 t square the whole raised to minus 1 by 2 j. So this is equal to minus 4 t into 1 plus 4 t square the whole raised to minus 3 by 2 I plus 2 into 1 plus 4 t square the whole raised to minus 1 by 2 minus 8 t square into 1 plus 4 t square the whole raised to minus 3 by 2 into j. Therefore dt by dt at t equal to 0 is, so here on substituting t equal to 0 you will get this as 0, so 0 I plus, you can see that this quantity is 0, so you are getting 2 j. Therefore kappa at t equal to 0 is 1 by modulus of v of 0 divided into dt by dt of 0. That is kappa at 0 equal to 1 by modulus of v of 0. Modulus of v of 0 is 1. So 1 by 1 into, we have modulus of t of 0 is modulus of 0 I plus 2 j. So this is square root of 0 plus 4. So that is square root of 4, that is equal to 2. Therefore curvature at 0 is 2. Therefore a rho at origin, that is rho is equal to 1 by kappa, that is equal to 1 by 2 at origin. Therefore center of the circle is 0 or rho, that is 0 1 by 2. Therefore equation of the oscillating circle or equation of the circle of curvature at 0 0 is x minus 0 the whole square plus y minus half the whole square equal to half square. So that is x square minus x square plus y minus half the whole square equal to 1 by 4. So this is the equation of oscillating circle to the parabola y is equal to x square at origin. So you can see that this is a better approximation than the tangent at origin to the parabola. So you can see these things using the GeoGebra. So you first plot y is equal to x square. So this is y equal to x square, and consider the circle x square plus y minus half square, that is equal to 1/4. So this is the oscillating circle, and you can see that the center is at (0.5). This is the oscillating circle to this parabola. You have, this is the oscillating circle or circle of curvature at the point origin to the parabola y is equal to x square. Now you can see the different oscillating circles at different points on the parabola in this video. You can see. So these are the different oscillating circles to the parabola at different points on the parabola. So out of which we have found just one, that is the oscillating circle at the origin. So that's all for the day. Have a nice day.